You make it, we mark it.
Hey everyone, this is Jeff of Tal Flaremouse. Today we have a fantastic looking slug that came all the way 71 Blackbird. And this is definitely my favorite airplane of all time. I love this plane. The Slug features a steel core housed in an aluminum, highly polished body. It's a beautiful looking slug, folks. The weight is just a little lighter than a Remington AccuTip. Not too heavy and not too light. And just like the SR-71, this slug looks fast just sitting in place. Now precision is important and Kyle nailed it as far as the outside diameter goes. Perfect. Now these would be considered a subcaliber projectile because they are smaller than the bore diameter. And if we were to shoot them as they are, they would just rattle down the barrel and not engage the rifling. And the simple solution to that is the Sabo system. These happen to be made out of an old shotgun shell. We now have what I call a sledgehammer fit. Very tight fit. We'll now engage the rifling, but also the Sabos will grip tightly onto that slippery slug. Underneath the slug, we'll use an FS-12 gas seal, a fiber wad, and set that slug right on top of that and put our Sabos around the slug just like that. With 35 grains of long shot, we should be able to achieve velocities of around 1600 feet per second. That should get the job done. Let's take one last look at these gems. Beautiful job, Kyle. I hate to shoot them, but let's go out and destroy them now.
Welcome back, Tal Flater folks. Officer Gregg, fresh out of rehab. Jeff behind the camera. Back out here with you today to test out a cool little submission sent in by Kyle Watkins in Wales. Not the big giant fish, but the country in the UK. I put my finger on this thing and it's actually a sharp little point. So he machines these rounds for us. We're gonna give them a try through a rifled barrel today and see what they do. So sit back, buckle up, and watch this awesome test.
What's all that noise in the background? Is that like the river?
We actually have water in California now, Jeff.
I know.
Temporarily, before we send it to
the ocean.
The ocean, the Japanese.
Test one against Kevlar.
When you're ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Here we go.
1556.
Stoutish recoil.
I loaded them kind of hot. Got a river going on over here.
Get a picture of it quick because there's no water in California.
Yeah.
So Brandon's waiting for us downrange with this blue X on his chest, and look at that. That thing is dadgum accurate.
These may be the best slugs that ever came out of Wales sent into us.
That's right.
Okay, wait. Now, it's not in the vest, right?
No. We checked it earlier. There is a big giant hole right there. Whoa, what happened?
Okay. But turn it around.
Look at that. Went through him, and check this out.
Out the back. Oh my gosh.
That's two levels of 3A body armor. That's like 6AA. In ballistic protection, and that thing rocketed right through. It's pretty impressive.
It's looking good.
He's impressive.
Hopes that these will go through the lead plate now. Maybe. Yeah. What do you think?
Through the lead plate?
Yeah.
I think they're light. I think they'll burrow in deep, but maybe not penetrate all the way through. Our best penetrators of the lead plate have been nice, heavy brass ones.
And slow. Yeah.
So these are kind of quick, and they're lightweight, so I'm predicting a deep burrow, but not all the way through.
Let's put up
the lead plate and give it a try. How about that?
Let's find out.
But first, let's review the high-speed footage. Now, if you look closely, you can see that it's trailing a yellow vapor trail. He had excellent stability, perfect precision, and it went through both Kevlar vests like they were made out of butter. Very impressive. And in case you were wondering, the yellow vapor trail was achieved by simply putting a drop of yellow food coloring in the cavity.
Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Got a primer strike on that one.
1538.
Here comes the Mach 71. You see a little bit of red food coloring in this one, but The slug slams into the plate and does not appear at first to have penetrated it. But look at that Kevlar. Something is causing that to fly back. Let's examine the damage.
Nice big round crater with the aluminum, what do you call that?
Aluminium?
Aluminium.
That's what they call it in Wales, I think.
Actually, in Wales, it's all in consonants. They have no vowels over there.
Okay, you see, I put a K on the back for Kyle.
For Kyle?
Yeah.
I thought it was for K. So check this out. Jeff was first to see this. We found the vest on the ground with the steel core stuck right in it. And that actually is buried in there pretty good.
Look, wow, there it is.
My goodness, that thing is untouched.
That thing was Loctite. He had some super duper Loctite.
Wow. That really, punched himself in there. So if this made it through here, science would say, we're gonna see a hole in the back of this. Look at that. So, hole big enough to be the slug. I mean the core, obviously.
Look at it, it's almost a perfect hole.
Yeah.
That's really cool. You can see the bottom of the...
Yeah, you can actually see the little sleeve in there that it was glued into.
Yeah.
This over here, that's crazy. Look at that.
Yeah. That's why I loaded them kind of hot, because I wanted to give these things the best chance of penetrating that plate, and he did it. The first slug from Wales that ever penetrated that plate.
Looks like the surface of the moon.
Yeah, it's all bumpy because it's been hit by a bunch of different slugs that haven't gone through. I think even the Russian Extreme Penetrator just bounced off that thing.
And I don't know, that core might actually make it through this thing. How wide is that?
Quarter inch, which is what, 6 millimeters or something?
It's almost a fourth of an inch, yeah.
Yeah.
So we're gonna balance it here. We're gonna put it at a little bit of a safety angle.
Yeah,
For our own selves. And let's shoot.
Yeah, that's a pretty good angle, so. But that's, you don't wanna shoot anything perpendicular, because
they tend to bounce back.
We try to advocate that all the time, you know.
If you've ever played billiards or, I don't know, throwing a rock against a window, you know you don't want it to bounce straight back on you.
Shot a Daisy BB gun.
Yeah. Even despite these angles, we often have stuff kicking back on us. So best we can do is angle it over there towards those. That there's a playground of kids right behind Jeff. We'd rather go over there.
Okay. I'm ready.
All right. On the orange circle. Here we go. Oh,
man,
all
sparks, yeah. I mean, 16, 12 feet per second.
Yeah, it felt like it.
Well, this is the highest velocity we've gotten so far, over 1,600 feet per second. The slug made a nice light show and everything, but did not penetrate the plate. Now, the slug didn't ricochet off the plate like one would expect. It came almost to a dead stop. Very interesting how that works. And in case you're wondering, we had just a drop of water in the nose of this one.
Happened.
Well, I was wrong and did not make it through the plate. Still crazy accurate. These are really, really accurate rounds. Hit where we wanted it to. I guess it made a shower of sparks. You guys will have seen it by now. Burrowed in there nice and deep. Tried to make it through. Little nubbin right there. But
this plate's tough to get through.
Here's the thing I found out front. This is cool. Look at that mushroom tip.
Didn't come back it with great velocity. Almost came to a dead stop and then just fell on the ground in front of it.
It was out here 10 feet in front of the target, but look at that mushrooming. It's a warm, warm mushroom tip you got right there with a little steel core.
Not bad.
That is pretty cool if I could hold on to it.
Darn it.
On the green square.
Blue tape there?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go. Ooh, that rang. Oh. Did you get hit by something? Came back and hit my foot.
This aluminum plate is 1 inch thick, or about 25 millimeters, and it's tough to get through, and I think the slug itself took most of the damage. The penetrator core is made out of mild steel. Now Kyle's already talking about making a new set of slugs with either a tungsten penetrator or a tool steel penetrator. Now that vapor trail is just barely visible in real time, as you can see in these frame grabs.
So I guess it hit near the blue tape, but not on it?
Yeah, it came really close.
So we had it at this angle right here, you can see, but look at that, burrowed right in there. And then Jeff felt this thing come back and kiss his foot.
Yeah, it's not little, hard or anything.
It's a little bent. This one's a little bent, unlike that other one we recovered. Look at that. And here we go. Oh my. Gee, how much did him?
1640.
Oh my.
The MACH-71 slug had enough power to penetrate both sides of this military grade helmet. And here we can see just the core itself kind of spinning off towards the left of the screen.
So we hit a little bit left because we're California. Har, har, har. Made it through. Check this out inside.
Oh, my God.
This is a hardened compressed Kevlar helmet.
That's a legit helmet.
Yeah, no steel. The same kind we use in the military and same kind we use in law enforcement. And look at that exit over there.
Oh, man.
So it tells you it made it through right there. Knocked his little Kevlar biscuit out. Exited the other side of the helmet. But when I came up here, what I saw from Brandon was...
What the heck?
It's actually stuck in there like that. The little steel core has exited on through. Made it through the helmet, of course, and out into the Netherlands. But that aluminum core is stuck in the side of his
head. Oh, man. Kyle's going to be on some kind of watch list in Wales now.
Frankenstein. Look at that.
And it's got a K on there.
Yeah, it's got a K for Kyle.
Yeah.
So we know it's got to be K for Kyle or control. That is a very lightweight little aluminum cylinder.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's... So the
Sorry, Brandon.
The steel core makes up a lot of mass there. Okay, that's pretty impressive.
Oh,
uh-oh.
It's coming down. Ah. If only we had a tarp.
Okay, I'm feeling pretty good about these things. Let's try a 50-yard shot.
50 yards, Jeff.
With iron sights, no less.
Iron sights, big old giant white golf ball-sized dot that covers the
right?
Covers its entire face at this point.
Okay.
Here we go on the chest, though. When you're ready.
Wait. Gotta make some last-minute camera adjustments. Okay, I'm ready.
Put the film in.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Miss.
No, I think it hit him. He rocked.
You're right, he did.
Yeah, I think that just smacked him in the vest.
I don't know. He didn't fall over.
No, but he wiggled. Yeah, I think that hit.
Have 50 yards. That's why we don't do 50-yard shots.
Well, technically we hit him both times.
You did.
We were high and left on both ones.
The strap's kind of in the way there.
Oh.
There
that's
you go.
That's what she said. We were high and left on both of those. Hit him in the neck and out the back of his shoulder on the first one. We tried to readjust. I put the dot right here in the center. Keep in mind that white dot on the front of my sight, when I put it down here at 50 yards, that thing is the size of a paper plate on his chest.
Yeah.
Covers almost everything, so it's tough to get precise. But the second one hit him here, hit above the Kevlar. So, of course, it went right through him and out the back of the vest. This is just fabric carrier, not Kevlar. So.
Okay.
Anyway.
Good attempt. Next time we'll stick to 40 yards.
40 yards is the magic distance for these rounds.
Yeah.
Let's try a couple of splashy, explodey targets.
Okay. Okay, the 5-gallon carboy.
That's like 1.7 liters.
Yeah, that's close to it.
In Canada, America's hat.
That's 22 yards or...
Which is almost 4 parseps.
That's like, what's that, 20 meters?
Sure, something like that.
Yeah.
I understood there would be no math.
And it's getting dark, so we gotta hurry.
All right, when you're ready, I'm gonna blow that jug.
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go. Curse splash.
Ballistic Jenny.
Here we go.
Oh, it's in the dirt.
See that light?
Now the gel shot kind of surprised me because I expected that penetrator slug just to zip through the gel block without really moving it too much. But we got a lot more energy dump than I expected. It was enough to throw the block back and knock the table over. And how that happened, we'll tell you in a minute.
Kind of cool.
So check this out. I don't know if you can see it down there, but There's a big giant cookie cutter of a hole here. Not something we normally see on most of our slugs.
Yeah, usually it's like a tiny pinhole.
Then, move this up here for you guys. Look at that big old giant wound cavity in there.
And that one had a little bit of red dye in the cavity and it just carried that all the way through.
Yeah, you can see that red dye, little pink in there, but
yeah.
Man, that is a gnarly wound channel in there. Popped out the end. This is what we found in the vest. The little
surprisingly, it mushroomed out.
Yeah.
That really surprised me.
It made you a little, almost like a little shot glass.
Yeah.
And then, of course, the steel core.
Yeah, we're moving around. I'm trying to zoom
here,
in and you're moving
let's
around.
Let's do this. Let's,
there you go.
Let's do this. I'll set them there.
Perfect.
That way I can break dance over here on the side.
That's impressive. I didn't think it would mushroom out like that, but that just shows you how much pressure. What are you doing over there?
Breakdancing.
Okay, as long as you aren't wearing animal costumes.
Jeff, I have tattoos now. I'm going to breakdance.
All right. Is that the last one?
That was the last one. We had 9 to shoot today.
Yeah.
We gave you a bunch of various targets. They were a lot of fun. These things were crazy accurate. They were fun to shoot. They had surprising penetration and damage.
Yeah.
So, good job, Kyle.
These might be the best slugs we ever got from whales.
Certainly the best Welsh slugs we've ever had.
Welsh, yes.
Welsh, that's right. So,
oh, they were
pip pip.
One of the best slugs, period, that we've shot.
So we thank you guys for joining us. This one was kind of fun to do. We're losing sunlight very fast.
Yeah, we lost it a while ago. I had to keep slowing the camera down.
We got a big storm coming in, so we will not be shooting again tomorrow, or for who knows how long. We're finally getting water in California. Who knows?
And there you have it, another episode of You Make It, We Mock It, where we give our viewers the chance to become the star of the show and show off their fabrication skills. Now, over the years, we've shown what works and what doesn't work, and I think Kyle was paying attention because he made these things work and they flew beautifully. Now, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. We appreciate that. We don't ask for anything else. And if you didn't like it, you know what they say, go make your own video. We'll see you next time.